Okay, it's an open invitation for any of you that are interested. If you will send me a video of yourself playing, I will critique and give you suggestions on whatever I can think of as far as what you've shown me in your video. So this one is from, looks like Xiao Lei Deng. And so I'm going to play it for you, and here we go. Stop there. Okay, in the very beginning, it looks like you're putting your bow down like this, okay? So your wrist is kind of slanted like that, slanted inwards, and what that immediately tells me is that you're using your wrist to push down, and that's not going to be very healthy for your wrist. First of all, it gives a very scratchy sound, but second of all, if you're doing that, it's going to wear out your wrist and make you really tired. What I would suggest doing, instead of putting it down like this, I would extend your arm, which usually means pulling your elbow back just a little bit. And if you're going to pull your elbow back, usually this part of your body right here is also going to extend backwards just a little bit. So instead, let me show you what you are doing, and this is what I would do. I would just extend it back, and what this does is it relaxes your wrist, and then when you pull, don't pull with your wrist, otherwise you get this scratchy sound. Pull instead with have your elbow lead the motion. Okay? What it does is it takes away a lot of that pressure and that crunching sound that you were producing with your wrist, and we're putting it into your elbow instead. Okay, so instead of, okay, so less wrist, more elbow and arm. It sounds a little bit like you're going. Sounds like you're kind of picking at it a little bit. I'd like you to do a little bit more of a brush stroke. So instead of, which seems a little like a pickaxe, a tiny pickaxe. What I want you to do instead is do a little bit of a brush stroke. And what that does is it loosens up the sound. It makes it so that the instead of it being an angular, sharp sound that doesn't last very long, we're trying to widen that sound so that you have more of a ringing sound. Okay, and you don't need that much pressure, particularly. Okay, so what I'm doing is I'm just lifting my bow off the string and letting it land, but without adding any extra force, so it just lands naturally. And I apologize, I don't know this piece, so I'm just going to be playing it the way that I hear it, whatever notes I hear. Okay, now watch your rhythm there. Make sure you're holding that for a full three counts, those two notes. So, or whatever bowing you're doing there. Okay, I also noticed that your shoulder is going up when you're coming up near the frog. Okay, you don't want to lift your shoulder, because if you lift your shoulder, you're going to tense muscles here, and that's going to cut off some circulation. You might knock yourself out. Okay, that's an exaggeration, but what it'll do is it pinches nerves up here, and so if you do that for a very long time, you're going to lose your ability to use your shoulder up here. So what I would suggest is to keep your shoulder down. Let's see. Okay, you can do that by, again, leading with your elbow as you're coming up the string. Instead of coming up like this to get your to the frog, I want you to keep your shoulder down and just use your forearm and your elbow. Okay, and what that does is it actually ends up making your bow angle this way. You see how it's tilted this way just a little bit? So it starts off, okay, this establishes another thing for you, is it keeps your contact point with the string at the exact same spot on the bow. See this? It's staying at the exact same spot on all the way up. And there are a couple videos that I found on YouTube that are very useful that explain that bringing at an angle here will allow your bow to stay at the same spot. Okay, now, let's see, I didn't do it very well there. Let me put my violin down and do it properly. Okay, so it's an angle. You're not doing it, if you do it completely straight on, your bow's gonna drift. So make sure that you're finding that angle that will keep your bow at the same spot in the string. Then you get a consistent sound. So. And no shoulder. Just use your arm. Okay, just be careful with your counting again. Dum. Okay, now I'm not quite sure what notes you're trying to play. Let's see, let me play it again. I'm not quite sure what notes those are supposed to be because I don't know the piece. And it's not going to let me, so never mind. Anyways, you'll want to check those notes that are right around here on the A string. That didn't sound right to me. Okay. So good video, and I appreciate you putting this on, and hopefully this will help. Let me know what else I can do for you.